here looking for a workout spot now since I moved to operation. So because I'm a lot closer to wilderness, I can do just that. So we're going up there to see if, just so I can see how long it takes to get up there, and then that way for further workouts I can bring up increasingly larger rucksacks. Okay, so we're pretty much at the base. This is Bell Mountain in Apple Valley. And I looked at it through Google Earth first before I came up here. It's pretty much began right here with these two columns of rocks leading up, so pretty cool. A lot of people have been through here and up to the top before, so pretty well established. Although this is a pretty dangerous area. I've already heard people shooting over the far side of the hill here, probably like 5Ks away. So when you're out in the desert, be aware that this is all California desert anyway. This is all BLM land, and most of it's open for shooting. So just be aware. If you guys are thinking about getting into the GoPro thing, this is being shot on a GoPro Hero 3 Black Edition. And it kind of sucks because there's no viewfinder. There's they talk about that you could sync it with your phone and everything, and it does work. But what happens is it sends the video signal to your Bluetooth, or through Bluetooth to your cell phone. But then what happens is as soon as you hit the record button, that signal goes out. So unless you have that backpack function attached to the back of it, it doesn't really, there's no real way to see what you're shooting, so you just gotta trust in the wide angle and hope you get it. But I've learned some things, some techniques that I've used with the Sony NEX-5N that I shot the past couple things with, and that is, you know, as a filmmaker, you gotta use. One of the rules is the rule of thirds. You break the screen down into thirds, both vertically and horizontally, and then you try and match that. So, as I'm looking this way, you should have this lead room in front of you. And what I've learned to do is point the lens. If I'm talking and the lead room should be to the right, what I do is I point the lens to my right ear, and that normally gives me some lead room here. And then vice versa. If my lead room is on the left, then I'll point the lens to my left ear. You can hear them shooting. I hope they're not shooting this way. That would really suck. And don't forget, in the summertime, you gotta look out for Jake. Always be on the lookout for Jake. The snake, that is. Never know where he's gonna be chilling. And now today, I really wish I brought my binos. All right. make sure if you're out in the desert and you're walking around on all these rocks and stuff, if you can't see on the other side of it where it makes positive contact with the ground, don't just step over it. Step on it, look over, because you don't know what's waiting on the other side. And that's all you need. A whole different brand of ankle biters. Okay, I'm gonna try and get a better angle up on these shooters, because I don't want I don't need any plinking going on around my feet. So I'm gonna see if I can see them any better. If you can see them, but there's two vehicles down there. I don't see any people, so I don't know where the shooters are or what direction they're shooting, and I really don't see anybody else around here. Not on the other side anyway, so I don't know if they see me and they're like, okay, we're done, or what. So, see if we can get higher and look down lower into that valley. Well, you know, you start going through all these rocks and you think you've got the trail, and then you look around and you realize there's no more beaten path, there's no more footprints. So it's like, where did the trail go? Normally you can see the wear marks, like right here. Would you even know? You see the loose dust, look, there's a footprint right there. And so now we've refound the trail. It winds up through here, wraps around and continues on. And then it went down here. I totally missed it. I was coming up here. Okay, they're shooting again. I think they're shooting up in that gully there. You can see the two vehicles, some white vehicle and another one. And in that clearing right down there, I think they're shooting up in that draw. That's what I think, because I don't see any people moving. So I think they're actually over that, inside the draw there, popping caps that away. So that's good. I don't hear any ricochets over here. So on we go, Charlie Mike. Yeah, you can see the path clearly now. It winds around all these footprints. The way up has been up here for years. Lots of travel. You always get the most dramatic views as the sun's rising. Hey, make sure too that when you're out here in the desert amongst the rocks, that you don't get tunnel vision. So it's easy to just stay focused on the trail and trying to find the beaten path, right? But you have to look wider, because just imagine, like, this rock right here was basically right at, you know, chest height. If you're not looking, there could be a snake sitting here, there, around there. So you have to have a wide angle field of view. It's really some great Shaolin scanning training when you're out here looking for bad guys, bad snakes. Trying to keep your eye on the beaten path. as well as Jake. Big old pit there. Anything in there? What about in those rocks right there in that shade? It's morning time, but the heat's starting to come out because they don't always rattle. So you gotta be checking every nook and cranny. Make sure you don't get surprised out here. Man, can you imagine? Avalanche from hell. Whoo! Final push, but the trail goes up this angle right here. Once we get on top of this saddle, the trail cuts all through those rocks up to that outcropping there and around it up to the top. So let's not waste any time, shall we? Clearly marked trail. Can't miss it. Serious trail angels over here, man. It's cool that other people are passionate about hiking and backpacking. And on up. A lot of memorabilia up here. Happy 4th of July. Pretty cool. Boy Scouts in the house. Stone keen again. I wonder if some kind of memorabilia. I'll have to check out the Boy Scout sites around here. Lots of signatures. Even a bra. Gotta love it. But wait, there's an epitaph. Let this flag stand for beer lovers throughout the land. BML or BMD. Can't really make that one out. But yep, let that flag fly. Awesome. Nice. More painted rocks. Let's say the sun's probably Silver Lake softball. And this ancient hieroglyphic is worn away. Quartzite Mountain. Back of the San Gabriels, that's the backside of Mount Baldy, the west, northwest side of Mount Baldy, Wrightwood. Down there is El Cajon Pass somewhere. Then we have Silverwood Lake. All about the Apple Valley right there. Farther down the valley is the Lucerne Valley. Now you're looking at Big Bear, Lake Arrowhead area. Again, this is northeast of it. So the top of the mountain continues. It's not exactly flat. Okay. Yeah. So that's the fabled Walmart distribution hub. I thought it was a prison, but apparently it's Walmart. To some, it might be the same thing. Okay. So, a little water, and we'll head on down. Alright, so it took me about probably 40 minutes to get up here. Walking time. That doesn't include all of the time that I set up the camera and all that kind of stuff. There's a lot of stuff you don't see that doesn't make the cut. Maybe even this clip right here. But probably about half an hour, 40 minutes to get up here as fast as possible. So that's cool, but down should be faster. We'll see. But you gotta watch out. The way down is a whole nother consideration with all this loose stuff. You gotta watch your step, gotta take it easy. It's going downhill where people get injured the most, where the most accidents happen. So that's where these trekking poles come in to play, because they work as a brake, basically. You put it in front of you and you walk up to it, and then you place and you walk up to it. And even then, you gotta work the switchbacks. Test every rock that you step on, because you don't want this sliding down if you put your weight on it. So you gotta make sure that it's safe before you step on it. So this is all loose. So you gotta take your time and make sure you're doing it the right way so that you don't kill yourself. So yeah. So on down there. That's where we're going. So we'll head on down and figure out how long total. But I'm thinking about an hour, maybe hour and 20 minutes up and back without filming. That's my thinking. But we'll see in a few minutes. You know, one thing about these trekking poles, there's especially on downhills, as far as a consideration, but there's definitely a way to use these things. And this is just my personal experience base, and not because I'm school trained or anything, but this is how you wear them. All right, stick your hand from the back of the loop. That way, the handle goes in the webbing, the strap goes in the web of your hand between your thumb and your forefinger. And what that prevents is, as you're going down, say you got a slippery hand and you're trying to stabilize yourself and you slip, you still have that positive, it's almost a passive control where you have no choice, but where you won't slip off of your pole, which, you know, could cause a broken pole, could cause a broken leg or an arm, depending on how far you fall, you know. But there's a certain way to use these things. And one of the safe ways that I found is, you know, not to walk past it on the descent. So you place your pole, walk up to it, place it again, walk up to it, place it again, walk up to it, and control your descent. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it because it worked for me. And there you have it. all done. Started at, what was it, 7:30, now it's about 9:15. Plus, shooting video en route, which means, I mean, if you guys watched Survivor Man at all, you know that it's kind of a pain in the ass. You know, you gotta set the camera down, do your walking, come back, get the camera, pick it up, take it with you. Not that this is all that much of a camera. I've really whittled down, at least for the traveling portions of my shows, my filming technique. So, without further ado, it's probably about 90 degrees out here now, 9:15 in the morning. So, I'm taking my ass to the movies. You guys have a happy 4th of July, or I hope your 4th of July was splendid. Happy new Independence Day again to Egypt. Hopefully it'll work out this time. For those of you interested in the movie I'm directing here in a couple weeks, there's a trailer now. Not really a preview because it doesn't really tell you what it's about, but the website tells you what it's about, so I guess you could put it into some kind of context. If you go to the website, abelspromise.com, or abelspromisethemovie.com, facebook.com/abelspromise. And yeah, have a happy 4th of July, and we'll see you out there.